presentation of EA Sports. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. It'll be Falcons football, and they trail here as we get back underway on EA Sports. And we will not have a run back here as the second half starts with a touchback. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And you have to think, Charles, down three scores already, they need to play an almost perfect second half to have a solid chance.
And that absolutely starts with finding some way to put together a touchdown drive here. They need to be smart, fast, efficient, get the ball to the end zone, and do it again multiple times in order to have a chance to win this game.
Meanwhile, Ryan's throw taken in by Ridley here. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a foot or so. Here's Patterson, and it's been like this all night long. Nowhere to run as they stop him behind the line. That backs him up 1 yard and brings up third down.
This defense is just flat getting after it. They have not given up much of anything in the run game. Case in point right there.
Yeah, that one's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
And that's a nice job there because you've got to play the ball, not the man when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties, and he's able to knock that one away.
I guess they figure they got to start taking some chances. Here's a big one in this third quarter as he'll go for it on fourth down. Ryan. And he will have the first down as he's brought down up near midfield. That was a pretty good job by the defense, I thought, right? I mean, they had to go to their check down, but still were able to get it done for the first.
Agreed. Anytime you can force them to come back to a receiver that's a little bit shorter in the route, you've done your job on defense, but still, they pick up the first down and get a fresh set.
Huge fourth down conversion. And he's going to get this past the 50 and into Giant territory. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. After the pickup of five, here's second and five. Here's Ryan. And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete.
Another attempt, another incompletion. And when I look at the scoreboard and where we are in this game, it comes to mind that they have to start getting the ball in the hands of their playmakers. Throw it to the guys that maybe can take a short pass and turn into a long gain or make people miss downfield. They've got to have points. And the guys who can put the ball in the end zone, they're the ones that need to touch the ball.
Yeah, boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. On fourth down, Ryan, and he's brought down. Can't do anything with the football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. The Falcons go for it, but it doesn't work out. And the Giants are going to get the football back. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And now you've got the clock winding down here in the third quarter. You're three scores to the good. What's your approach on this drive?
Too early to fully commit to playing the clock game. Yet at the same time, you're also not going pell-mell like you would in two-minute offense. This is what NFL offense is called, four-minute football. Take the clock out of the game a little bit, wind it down, but at the same time, keep advancing the ball down the field.
Looking to throw on second down. Jones completes it to Evan Engram. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40.
This is just more of the same. This defense has had no answer on a lot of these throws. They've let these receivers run wild. And here's another complete.
completion for good yardage.
So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. A give to Barkley out of the gun. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he will take it on in for a giant touchdown. Saquon Barkley, 39 yards. And the Giants are able to extend their lead in the final seconds of this third quarter. Gano the extra point, and that makes the score 28-0. Touchdown here to kick it away. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned into 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do and the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down.
Caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain, so now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
Gonna do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. They'll run on first down. It's Patterson. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4.
It's interesting, going into this game, there was so much talk from both sides about who would control the line of scrimmage. I think we've seen who has it in this one so far.
Well, they bottled him up. He's barely averaging over 3 yards a carry right now. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon. Alert three.
Throwing now, Ryan on first down. And that is caught. It's Ridley. Touchdown, Falcons. Calvin Ridley, 44 yards. And the Falcons are finally into the end zone here in this fourth quarter. So they will get on the scoreboard here. Give them credit for that. Too little, too late, but no zero. Are you? You're going slow clap on me.
Not very nice, is it?
No, but they haven't been very nice on offense. It's been a struggle. Extra point by Koo, up and good. And that'll cut the lead back down to 21. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. Taking it about the 1. And he's going to be out of bounds here as the run back will leave him shy of the 20-yard line. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you score.
And now off to the races, down the right side. And he will take it on in for a giant touchdown. Saquon Barkley. And the Giants are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. extra point. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now, as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And he'll be brought down at the 28-yard line, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone gets him 3 more. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons' offense at the line. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
On first down, Ryan. Airing it out, looking for Ridley. Oh, he rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked up by the USC man, Adoree Jackson. And a great return as he gets this all the way down close to the 30-yard line. Well, just another reason to celebrate there on the defensive side with the interception, and this is a game that they clearly have firmly in their grasp.
Yeah, a lot of handshakes, a lot of hugs, a lot of smiles. It's been their day.
A first down carry for Barkley. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5. Fourth quarter, you've got the lead. You have to stay in bounds and run that clock. Coaches, that'll drive them crazy.
Sacrifice a yard or two if you have to. Just go down, inbounds. Keep that
touchdown. Evan Ingram, his second touchdown of the night. And thanks to the interception, the Giants' offense cashes in with 6. Gano now to add the extra point. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see when they decide to do a play calling, because a one play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
On 2nd and 10, Ryan. And that one off the mark behind him, incomplete.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, 4th quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. On 3rd down, Ryan. He completes it to Ridley. And he is going to have a Falcons 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. To throw again is Ryan. And this one is incomplete.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
2nd and 10. He throws there, incomplete.
We've seen this quite a few times in this game. Offensive line unable to keep leverage, unable to keep people away, facing a lot of pressure. Fortunate just to get rid of it.
One of the reasons they're down is that inability, though, to stop the pressure. We saw another example of it there.
Base,
Ryan. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration, the body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Here we go. It's Ryan on fourth down. And yet again, Ryan is intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Jalen Smith. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six and a Giants touchdown. That's the story of the game. They've been suffocating all game long on defense. They were suffocating there again in a big way.
And they've done it not just by out-athleting them, which is often the case, but by being able to adjust to anything they tried to throw at them and beating them to the punch each and every time. This was a defense that was well prepared.
Extra point try good by Godot. And the lead will swell by one more. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. The return man down to a knee, and this will come out. To the 25-yard line. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And they gave up the pick six, and now they'll be looking to right the ship here. Now, as a quarterback, are you a little more cautious this go around?
You should be, just because after what you gave up, but you can't be so cautious as to just really take things in, and now you're not going to play loose enough to give your team a chance to score. But you still have to be careful, because those defensive guys, I know the reputation defense guys can't catch. All evidence to the contrary on that last possession, though.
So the incompletion, and now it's second and 10, again from the 25-yard line. Patterson complete, and they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. Throw is Ryan. That's caught left side to tight end Pitts. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 41. He was unable to shake free there. They'll cover him for a loss of a yard. So it's Falcon football as we welcome you back. They're looking at second down now as they search for a consolation score. To throw again on second down. Ryan, and his throw is incomplete. At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense, they're just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
And this is actually the easy part of the game for them because, just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. But they've blanketed the field the entire game using a variety of coverages.
Too late. But he does get in for six.
No wonder you're grinning. You just beat me in our fantasy league.
Indeed I did, my good man.
That's a whole lot of points still to be down. But congratulations, they're still fighting, and they scored another touchdown.
Like my old high school coach used to say, Charles, he said, sometimes you win, sometimes you lose, and sometimes you wish you never had showed up.
Could have saved the gas money, the hotel, what have you, huh?
Ku able to connect on the extra point as they make the score just a slight bit more respectable here in the final quarter of play. Following the touchdown, here's Ku to kick off. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And a few kneel downs should come very close to finishing this one off, depending on whether or not we see any defensive timeouts. They still have two, but using them would just be prolonging what's really already been decided. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. Again, it's Barkley. Down he goes at the 23, a pickup of 4.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
On third down, Barkley. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 182 yards on the ground for him now as he has gotten better, really, as the night's gone on. On first down, Barkley. And getting this